Joe Biden had another viral moment. This time, it's with his pathetic attempt at Hispanic outreach. Here's what happened.
I just have one thing to say. Hang on here.
All right. There you go. Dance a little bit, Joe. Come on. I tell you what,
if I had the talent of any one of these people, I'd be elected president by acclamation.
How do you do, fellow Hispanics? Or shall I call you Latinos or Latinas? Or Latinx? I will say and do whatever you want me to if you vote for me. I won't actually give you health care. No. I won't actually do a Green New Deal. No. But I will play Despacito on my phone for you. Oh, I hate this so much. I hate this so much. Politicians always appeal to people through culture when they can't appeal to you through policy. And that's Democrats and Republicans. They will always appeal to you with culture when they can't appeal to you through policy. And that's where we are. This is, you know what this reminded me of? The Hillary Clinton, I carry hot sauce in my purse. Fellow blacks. Do the blacks like me? Are you going to vote for me? I carry hot sauce in my purse. When she was on with Charlemagne the God. It was such an obvious pandering moment that everybody was like, oh, don't tell me you said that. Or again, this is like a Pokemon go to the polls type moment. Or Biden and Kamala just getting in whatever video game that was where they're in it. They will give you whatever they think you want on culture and on symbolism. I fully expect at some point for Joe Biden to take a knee and put a fist up and say Black Lives Matter. At some point in this campaign, he'll do that if he hasn't already done it and I just missed it. Because he'll be like, whatever you want, as long as we can keep the status quo going as it is. As long as corporations can keep ripping people off. As long as the military-industrial complex can move along without a hitch, and people get very, very rich off of endless war. Wars, plural. As long as his buddies on Wall Street keep getting wealthy, he's like, I'll say it, do whatever you want. I'll wear a Black Lives Matter shirt. I'll do whatever you want. Despacito, I'll play it on my phone. I'll sing it. I'll learn the lyrics and I'll sing it. I'll dance. You want me to salsa, bitch? I'll salsa for you. And I despise this. I despise this. And the other thing is, if they don't recognize now how serious a moment this is historically, not just because of Trump, but because of everything happening in the country between COVID and the economy imploding, worse since the Great Depression, if they don't take this seriously now, they will never, under any circumstances, take it seriously. Because 46% of Americans are having, quote, serious financial problems. Serious financial problems. That's half the country can't pay the bills. So you know what that means? If that number went up to 60%, if that number went up to 85%, Biden would be running the exact same campaign. Because there's no sense of urgency, because he is in his little bubble, disconnected from the pain of real people. And so he's running as if the year is 1996. That's how he's acting. Like it's 1996. They're all Trump is acting like this and Biden is acting like this. They're acting like we're not in a new Great Depression because of COVID when we are. They're acting like we don't have a pandemic that killed 200,000 Americans. Vapid cultural appeals. Are you kidding me? And then, by the way, we'll get to a story later. They're not accepting blame for the fact that Biden's not doing too well with Hispanic voters. Well, let's see. Who did well with them in the primary? Bernie. What did Bernie do? Talk directly to them and talk directly to their material well-being and interest. Working class people. Hey, I'm pro-union. I'm going to get you health care. I'm going to get you higher wages. This is what it took. But those are the things Biden is not in favor of. So what does he do? It's all cultural nonsense. Despacito. Oh, it's not going to stop, man. It's not going to stop. I fully expect this nonsense to continue. And it will get me pissed every single time. I've said it before, I'll say it again. I'd rather you do nothing than do the pandering, the condescending pandering, where you try to appeal over cultural issues. You're not our friend. You're not our buddy. You're not cool. We want healthcare. We want healthcare and we want to end the wars and we want to rebuild the country and we want people to not die in the pandemic. This is what we want. No more how do you do, fellow kids? How do you do, fellow Hispanics? I can't deal with this, man. And you wonder why. The largest voting bloc in the country is people who don't vote. You wonder why? Because most people are normal people who look at the actions of a guy like Trump and now a guy like Biden, and they're like, this is fucking gross. I want nothing to do with these people. Oh, thank you for playing a song that's popular on your phone in attempt to reach out to people, Mr. I voted for the Iraq War and NSA spying in the Patriot Act and outsourcing deals like NAFTA. Thank you. Very kind of you. Hopefully the song that you played on your phone overrides some of the pain that was caused by the war that killed 200,000 innocent civilians in a country that didn't attack us.